Hello all, welcome to my channel. Today I am sharing a simple way to make Jowar roti. Jowar is a gluten-free grain. If you are looking for a gluten-free diet, this is a good option. Jowar also helps in better control of blood sugar, which is why the flour is recommended for diabetes. It is also an excellent source of micronutrients. So let's get started into our preparation. In a bowl, I am adding 2 cups of water, 1/2 a teaspoon of ajwain, also called as carom seeds, this is completely optional, and a pinch of salt. Let it come to a boil. In this stage, keep the flame in low and add 2 cups of jowar flour. Make sure you add the same amount of flour for the amount of water you have taken. Now turn off the flame and mix it properly. Cover it with a lid for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, remove the lid and knead the dough for about 5 to 7 minutes. 5 to 7 minutes kneading is must. If you feel hot to touch, you can use a cloth to knead the dough. The dough should be soft like chapati dough. If the dough is hard, you can sprinkle some water and knead well. Now divide the dough into 2 equal parts and knead it until it becomes soft. To keep the dough moist for a long time, I am covering it with a cloth and sprinkling some water on top of it. Make equally sized small balls out of the dough. Dust the rolling surface with the flour. Make sure there isn't any traces of water. Dip the dough in the flour and flatten it by pressing uniformly. Start rolling thinly with the help of rolling pin. Use flour if needed. Do not put too much pressure on it. Roll it smoothly and gently. And flatten it uniformly with the help of rolling pin. Now heat the tawa, put the flattened dough onto the hot tawa. Always remember to keep it in low flame when making jowar chapati. If you keep it in high flame, it won't cook from inside. Now dip your hand in water and start wiping off the roti from top, removing the excess dough. Wait until the water evaporates. Then flip it to the other side. Press gently and cook all the sides. Make the remaining rotis with the same procedure. You can serve it with any curry. It goes well with brinjal curry or dry garlic chutney. You can see here how soft the roti is. If you found the video useful, please like and share the video. Please comment if you want me to post new recipes. Please subscribe and click on bell icon to get more updates. Thank you.